office, Sally Drawlot was setting up a banner with the words anger management on it, as she had been given a job by her brother, Jone Drawlot Jr, to help Toons by being a therapist, as it was her dream job, and the first thing she wanted to do was help Toons with anger issues, as she had seen a lot of them on TV as a child. There, it's perfect. Just then there was a knock at the door. Oh, that must be the first Toon to arrive. He went to the door and opened it. The Toon standing on the porch was a young human man with black hair and a shirt with the word jerk on it and blue pants. Hello, you must be here for anger management? Yes, I am. Well, can I have your name? What? You don't know my name? I thought you Drawlots knew every Toon by name. Well, I'm sorry, but you look like a fairly recent character from a show I have yet to see. Well, sadly, you can't. It got canceled too soon, and I'm still mad at the people from Discovery Family for getting rid of it. Wait, isn't your name Dan? And didn't you have your own show on what was once called The Hub, but now Discovery Family? Yes, it was called Dan Versus. And someday, I'm going to get my revenge on them. Okay, well, why don't you take a seat until the others get here? Fine. The next Toon standing at the porch was an octopus. He was blue, and all he wore was a brown shirt. Oh, hello, Squidward. Are you here for... Yes, I am, and I'm only doing this because I need some time away from SpongeBob. Okay, why don't you take a seat? Squidward took the seat next to Dan. Hey, are you like an alien or something? What? No, I'm an octopus. Geez, sorry. The next Toon on the porch was a kid with hairs on his head. He was wearing a yellow shirt and light blue pants. Hello, thank you for coming, Eddie. Thanks, my mom made me come here after she said I needed this, which I don't think I do. Well, you never know if you try it. Why don't you take a seat? Okay. Eddie sat next to Squidward and Dan. So, what are you guys in for? Getting away from my annoying neighbor? I picked a fight with a cop and they said either I go to anger management or go to jail. Wow, that's pretty cool if you ask me. Last Toon to arrive was a gumball machine with arms and legs. Hello, aren't you Benson, the guy who runs the park in Cartoon City? Yes, I heard you could help me with my anger. Why, yes, please take a seat. Benson sat down in between Eddie and Squidward. Hey, aren't you like a gumball machine? Yes, and aren't you the kid who was trying to scam people for jawbreakers at the park with his friends that one time by doing a magic show? No, that was my twin. He loves jawbreakers. Okay. Sally sat in the front with a clipboard and a pen in her hands. Okay, now that you're all here, I figure the first thing we should do is get to know one another by telling me what makes you angry the most. Dan, why don't we start with you? What makes you angry the most?
Oh, that's easy. Everything.
What do you mean by everything?
I mean, I practically hate everything.
Can you give us some examples?
Well, there's Canada, technology, weather, plants, doctors, dentists, traffic, fancy restaurants, and those ponies who I swear are the reason I was canceled.
Okay, now from my understanding, you're upset about being canceled. And you're not alone. A lot of Toons go through with the whole being canceled thing. And some even attempt to blame it on others. And not only do you blame it on the people on Discovery Family, but you also blame the ponies because they got more fame than you did.
Yes, and not to mention their fans even made me cross over with them, which is so not me.
Oh really? Can you tell me what this crossover thing is?
Well, it's a web series where I'm roommates with Twilight Sparkle, this pony Fluffball, and this evil bug pony queen, and it's stupid, I tell ya!
Okay, I see, but you know what I think? Sometimes it can be hard on Toons like yourself to no longer have the audience you once had. But there is one thing you should know. There are humans who I'm sure want to see you in action once again. But yet, it depends whether it will happen or not. But... who knows? But I know somewhere there are some humans who think you deserve a second chance. Do you get what I'm saying?
Huh, you know, I never really thought of that, especially coming from the real world, and I didn't think they cared. Even if I never got a finale, they still care.
Ha 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 ha! You never got a finale? How lame! I got a finale and it was great. Everyone loved it. It was like a big TV movie for crying out loud. But you got nothing? Ha 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 ha! Eddie, well if you're going to act that way, why don't you tell us what makes you angry the most?
Well, what makes me angry is my scams not going as planned. But what makes me feel better making fun of toons who never got an ending, like Jerkface over there?
That's it!
Dan jumped out of his chair and started beating up Eddy. Oh my goodness! Should we do something?
Nah. Then the door closed.
Okay, while Dan and Eddy are taking their fight outside, why don't we continue with the questions? Squidward, what makes you angry the most?
Annoying neighbors. Because, yes, and I have to work with them on 3 different shows.
Okay, Benson, what about you? Employees who are lazy and don't bother doing work.
Oh, yes, I see. I mean, being the boss isn't easy.
You think?
Just then, Jone entered the room.
Hey, Sally, why are Dan from Dan Versus and Eddy from Edd and Eddy fighting outside?
Oh, don't mind them, Jone. Eddy just made fun of Dan for not having a series finale.
Okay, but they are destroying everything outside.
What?
Everyone went outside and watched the fight continued.
Maybe this wasn't a good idea.